Hello friends, I am Amiranul Nizami and today we are going to learn the simply supported beam in Abacus. So let's start. So the problem is as follows. A simply supported beam of a span length L carrying a uniformly distributed load. So we have to find the deformed shape, deflection, magnitude of the deflection and the reactions at the supports in Abacus, and also verify it with the MATLAB code results. So this is the simply supported beam with a uniformly distributed load where a span is 1000 and minimum number of nodes required here are 2. So we also know that when there is the concentrated moments or forces, then we have to introduce the nodes there. But here we are seeing that only distributed loads are acting, that is uniformly distributed, and no other forces are acting here. So one nodes would be here at this point and another nodes would be at this end. So it is the minimum number of nodes. So we can make with the one part only. Otherwise, if there is any, if there is a concentrated loads or any concentrated moments at any point, then what we have to do? We have to choose the nodes at this point, one nodes, then at this point, where the concentrated load is acting, that would be another node, and the concentrated moments, then there this should be one node, and this fourth point this would be one node. So then minimum four nodes we have to select. Otherwise, if this is not the force, so if it is not this force is not acting here, this is not acting, only this distributed load, then we can remove this portion and this would be only, what we can say, 1 2. So minimum two nodes means one element, only one element. Okay, that's the minimum requirement because Abacus is a finite element package. Okay, so we have to analyze in this manner. So in the next slide, so simply supported beam, so we are solving beam problem using Euler-Bernoulli beam theory. So in Euler-Bernoulli beam theory, we know that there is no shear deformation. So no shear deformation is considered. And the shape functions are cubic in nature. So we know that the shape functions here is in the cubic form. So we have studied before that 1 minus 3x square by L square plus x cube by L cube. In this manner, that is the shape function. So it is the cubic polynomial. So this is also called Hermite polynomial. So these points we should know the background, that we are telling it cubic. Okay, so it is the Hermite polynomials or cubic in nature. So when we will use Abacus software, then there we have to select these things. Somewhere it may be written in the cubic nature or Hermite polynomial. So we have to select that for Euler-Bernoulli beam. This would be the case. So let's erase this part. And now, so we introduce the nodes wherever there is change in the cross section or application of the loads. So there, when there is the loads or the change in cross section or the support conditions, then we generally use the apply the nodes there. So we just studied before. So this is our beam, and here it's, this one is the node at this point, and the second node is at this point. So two nodes are there, so one element we can say minimum. Then we will go to the Abacus, and now we will just start our Abacus software. So we will just go to Abacus, and we will first step, we will save the file. So we will just, we can just click here save. And we are going to solve the simply supported. So we will just sim sub code beam So we will just click OK with this name. Now the first step is just to create part. We will create a part. So it's 2D planner, deformable. We will select the wire. We can take here, we can give 5000 here for this. Continue. Now just we select here this point, create isolated point. So the first point would be 0, 0, and the second point is, because L equals to 1000, so it would be 1000, 0. Okay, so the second point is 1000, 0. We will just select it. Now we will connect these two points. We'll just connect these two points. Escape. Done. So this part is over. Now we will come to the second point, that is the property, and we will just go to the property and create material. So click here, and because Euler Bernoulli in this beam we are not taking the self weight, so we are not going to give the density here. So we will directly go to the mechanical part, and there we will go to elastic part. So elasticity, there would be elastic. So here we will click elastic. Now here Young's modulus, so we are not taking the any RCC or steel, we are just taking general. So we are just putting the value 1 here, and the Poisson's ratio we are just giving it 0, because for Euler Bernoulli beam it's 0. We will just click it. Okay, now we will just create section. So it's beam, and we will just continue. Then we will click here, we will take the rectangular section, we will just make it continue. A, we are giving the width equals to 12 and B equals to 1 in such a manner that to make E into I equals to 1 for a simple cases, that's why we are just doing. Okay, now so we have already created section. Now we have to assign the section. So we will just click here and select the regions where we have to assign. So we will just select the regions here, selected. We will just done. So the section is already chosen, then we will assign. It is got assigned here. What it's telling, it is telling assign the beam orientation. We will just click here, you will just select the regions to get the sign, and we will done. So this section is also assigned, and we will just click OK. Now this is done. So we can go for the next, or we can see it again, that select the regions to be assigned a beam section orientation. So we can see whether it's got done. Enter. Okay, we will just go to next assembly. We will just click here, assembly parts. Okay, we will go to next step. Just go here, create output file. So let me see. First we will go here, we will just create the step as static general. Continue. Okay, then it is create field output. So what we want, we will create field output. Continue. We will just see stress and my stress. We will just get the total strain part. We will just see U translational displacement rotations and also the reaction force and moments in RT and RM. Okay. So now we will go to the next, which is load, and here create load case. So load case we will just see. So here it is distributed load, means it's nothing but a pressure. Distributed load is pressure here, so we'll just click pressure and we'll just click here continue. We'll select the beam where we have to apply load. So it's asking that magenta or yellow. So from in the downward direction the load is acting, so we have to choose the color magenta. So we'll choose here magenta with a magnitude of 1. So we have just provided 1 here, then we'll click OK. So it's a distributed load acting there. Okay, now create boundary conditions. So now okay, boundary conditions left and hinge, we can say left and hinge supports. So left and hinge here, we will just click continue. So we will select this and click, because select the regions to the boundary condition, we have selected that point, we will say done. Then it will ask, so hinge supports, we know that at this point no horizontal rotation, horizontal translation, not vertical translation, rotation can be allowed, so we will allow it. Okay, so it is the hinge support where neither horizontal movement nor vertical movement would be there, but rotation is allowed here. Now next point, so we will go to the next, we will just click the boundary condition, we'll go BC2 where we will say right and which is roller support. So roller we can see, and we will click here continue, select the regions for the boundary condition. Here it's giving select the regions, so we will select the region, we will click here, we will say done. Then we know that at this end it is the roller support, so roller horizontal translation is allowed but vertical is not allowed, so means U2 direction is not allowed, which is 0 here. Okay, rotation and vertical horizontal would be allowed, therefore it's only roller. So we'll click here done. Now we'll go to next step, which is mesh. So we will now mesh it. So meshing here, we will just click, so it will show dismiss. So we will just go, we'll just click part, then we will again click and we will go to mesh. Then when we will click it, it will show the value. So it is 100, it's showing. We can make 50 or 40 elements here. So we will just click apply. So almost 40 element it's choosing. Okay, now we will go here, okay, to the mesh part, yes. Then we will just click here, assign element type, select the regions to be assigned. It's telling the select the regions to be assigned here, so it is the region, so we will assign the select the regions. We will just click, we'll say done. So what it is asking, standard beam geometric order is linear, and beam type shear flexible or cubic formulation. Right now we have discussed in the slides that it is Euler Bernoulli, so no shear, cubic formulation, because shape function was cubic in nature or Hermite polynomial, so that's why we will choose this value. Now it's, we will just click okay, it's done. Now next we will go to the job, create job. So click create job, job mode, continue. Okay, now we will just check data check, click there data check. Now it's checking, so wait for a bit. So that check's complete. Now we will submit. After data check, we will submit. So we will submit. Okay. So it's running. It will take some time to respond. and it's completed. So therefore we can now see the results. So we will click on results. So we will go to the this what string plot contour on the deformed shape. So we want to know the deformed shape of it. So it's here, the deformed shape. Since we know the deformed shape of a simply supported beam is in this manner, so we have seen here, and it's showing the one which is a stress value, but we are interested here mainly in translational displacement UT. So we will just see UT. So what is the translational displacement? So 1.3 × 10⁻¹⁰, order of 10, it's maximum red. So here it is the maximum displacement at this position it's showing, which is 1.300. okay, and we can also see
RF.
Let's see. So RF magnitude. So at this end and this end, the reactive forces are it's showing. So plus 5 × 10⁻². So this is the both end reaction, because distributed load is equal. So both end is red here, we can see. So maximum forces would be there only. So that's why it's of the order 5 × 10⁻². So 10⁻²² order magnitude. So now we will also check it with the help of a MATLAB code. So let's see. We will just open the MATLAB. And MATLAB basic examples, a simply supported beam having uniformly distributed loads. So let's check it. Let's run the program. So unrecognized variable E. So just let me check. So enter the number of elements, how much number of elements we want to take. Suppose we are taking, there we have provided 40 elements, so here also we will take 40. Just click. So here some error, it's showing error. Seem to double. So let me see. Just a minute. I have done this. Control X. Control V. Let's see. So let's see, it's the beam which is simply supported results. So it's the displacement, it's showing the displacements here. So 0.01302 in the y direction, negative of these displacements. And the reactive forces, we can also see the reactions. First point 0.4875 and second 0.4875. This is the reactions at both end. So here we see the magnitude. This is the magnitude which was there showing 0.48 roughly, which is 5, and the displacement magnitude what we are getting, displacement is 1.3 to 10 power order 10. So there we are also getting the displacements. So here we are getting the displacements here. So our results got verified with Abacus and the MATLAB. So in the next video we will just see with the fixed end. It was a simply supported case. Then we will see the fixed beam case. So till then, have a good day. Thank you.